Eternal Father, I offer you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. May the love and mercy of God be with you. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you asked your disciples a personal question to know whether they had understood who you were. Peter, on their behalf, said, "You are Christ, the Son of the living God." We kindly beg you to send us your Holy Spirit to guide us to all truth about you, and so be eager to proclaim your true identity to the entire world through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear good listener, today, Thursday, the 5th of August 2021, our gospel is taken from Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 to 23, and our theme is, Who is Jesus for you? Today's gospel is presented in the style of an examination room, where a teacher examines his students after the end of an academic period to assess their performance. In the same way, today's gospel presents Jesus, the teacher, examining his students, the disciples. Let us look at the questions he sets for them. The examination he gives them is in two sections. The first question is a general one, while the second is particularly personal. The first question he asks the disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" This question is directed to the 12 disciples to ascertain whether, according to their research, the people Jesus had taught and had sent them to had really understood who he was. The disciples quickly responded to him, saying, "The people say that he is John the Baptist. Some say that he is Elijah, and others say he is Jeremiah or one of the prophets." With such responses, it is clear that the people that Jesus had preached to had not understood him. They remained at the level of crowds. The people give different answers because they have not made a personal experience with Jesus. As we saw in the previous gospel readings, these people fail to know him. They are the same people who search for Jesus to force him to become a king. They run after Jesus for bread. They are the same people for whom Jesus does miracles, do not understand him. They only look at him as a son of the carpenter, son of Mary, and fail to recognize his being God. They have not understood the kind of kingdom he represents. They still look at him with human eyes. Blessed Karakoti says, "We are all born original, but many die as photocopies." Indeed, you and me die photocopies when we fail to come out of the crowds and make a personal adherence to Jesus, who is our way, our truth, and our life. The people in the text, so to say, remain photocopies. They fail to know Jesus because they have not made that personal experience with Jesus. The question now comes to you, my dear good listener. Who is Jesus for you? Which personal name can you give him? Jesus gives them the second question, which, as we said, is particular and personal. He asks them thus, "But who do you say that I am?" With this question, Jesus wants to know whether his disciples, whom he chose, who have been with him, have transcended the level of the crowds and made a personal experience with him. As the saying goes, it is good to trust, but it's better to check. Jesus trusts his disciples, but he wants to verify whether they know him in person. It is Peter, on behalf of the others, who says, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Oh yes, Peter gives a perfect answer. One would perhaps say Peter was right to say a correct answer because he had made a personal experience with him. My dear good listener, for you and me to pass a similar test, we must have a personal experience with Jesus. Who do you say Jesus is for you? Jesus proclaims that Peter's confession is a gift from God. It is not from human understanding. It is by God's grace that Peter knows and says the correct answer. In John chapter 16, verse 12, Jesus says that when the Spirit of God comes upon the disciples, they would be guided to know all the truth about Jesus. It is therefore clear that you and me need the Holy Spirit to guide us so that we can make a personal profession of faith. My dear good friend, you and me will pass the test of this world only when we are united with God, who is love and mercy itself. We need to cultivate a personal relationship with God. Only then can we have correct answers to the challenges in our families, at our workplaces, in schools, in our churches, etc. However, without being connected to Jesus, we make wrong choices and make wrong results. Towards the end of today's gospel, Peter fails a test. He doesn't understand why Jesus declares that he's going to Jerusalem and there he will be rejected and even killed, but rise again on the third day. Peter rebukes Jesus saying, "God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you." Can you imagine Peter rebuking his own master? This time Peter is reasoning like a human being. That's why Jesus responds to him in a very hard way. "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have in mind the concerns of God, but merely human concerns." My dear friend, in the first case, Peter answered correctly, because he was connected with God's Spirit. In the second, he was disconnected with God's Spirit, and that's why he makes a total blunder. We find this same experience also with Saint Faustina, who at one moment, Jesus asked to make a novena with his fellow sisters in the convent, but failed because of human concerns. She was taken by circumstances of the day. She confesses that God's presence left her and her soul was dominated by darkness. However, after receiving confession, God's presence enveloped her again. She learned from that moment that God's grace must be received just as God sends it in the way he wants, and one must receive it in that form under which God sends it to us. May we pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we beg you to send us your Holy Spirit to enable us to know the truth about you and to discern the holy will of your Father, and so gladly follow you according to God's will. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the God who is love and mercy bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.